Livy and I grew up close. Close in age, close in sharing a room, playing the same sports, and sharing the same friends. Closeness that sometimes came with a fight, but nevertheless shaped us into the strong friend, close sisters that we are today. We grew up helping each other. She would help me with my spelling words, and I would help her find the perfect outfit. We have watched each other grow into adults, and as much as I would like to say we like to be teenagers, again, I love the stage that we are in now. I loved all versions of my sister in their own way, and maybe not all while they were happening. She was my little shadow growing up. She was little Boz in high school. She went to Penn State, traveled the world, got an amazing job at PwC, found her hubby, bought a house, and is now a gorgeous bride. All of these things, and my personal favorite of her is being an aunt. The way I see her with my son makes me the proudest to call her my sister.
A 40 HP Johnson on a flat bottom metal boat. Coke cans and BB guns, barbed wire and old fence posts. 8-point bucks in autumn and freshly cut cornfields. One arm out the window and one hand on the wheel. Some things just go better together and probably always will. Like a cup of coffee and a sunrise. Sunday drives and time to kill. What's the point of this old guitar if it ain't got no strings? Well, pouring your heart into a song that you ain't gonna sing. It's a match made up in heaven, like good old boys and beer and me, as long as you're right here.
It's very similar. Just as Allie was mentioning, it's very similar in the way that they have a competitive relationship. I mean, they're both like, hey, you know, let's compete a little bit, but they love each other. It's a beautiful thing. So Liv, you just keep that competitive nature, keep Luke fresh, and just keep him away from the sake, okay? Keep him away from the sake.
Now, Olivia and Luke, you two look gorgeous, picture perfect as always. Have you ever seen a picture of Olivia and Luke and said, oh my God, wow, that picture is beautiful? Well, that's because it is. Their relationship is what real love is about. You feel it when you're with them. When I heard my sister met a boy down in Sea Isle and I was gonna meet him, I was like, oh my God. I couldn't wait till the day my sister met a man that made her this happy. As an older sister, you always want what's best, and Luke is what's best.
As I look out through the crowd here tonight, I just want to thank everyone for being here. I see a lot of familiar faces that I haven't seen in a while, and it's a beautiful thing. I mean, it really is awesome. And for what better reason for all of us to be here tonight than to celebrate the love of two of our favorite people, I love you guys. I love you guys.
I'd spend 10,000 hours, 10,000 more. Oh, if that's what it takes to learn that sweetheart of yours. And I might never get there, but I'm gonna try. If it's 10,000 hours or the rest of my life, I'm gonna love you.
This little girl who sat on my lap, helped me eat my dinner, who wrapped her little arms around my neck and gave the biggest hugs, has grown up. I knew someday it would be somebody else's luck to have her love. I did not know how lucky she would be to find somebody like Luke. Although I should have known, I will always be here. I will always be here to help. When you become a father, especially the father of a little girl, you know your job, more like your need, is to protect, comfort, encourage, and love her. You also know that someday someone else will have these tasks. Now, for the second time, I have the great fortune of knowing there will be someone to protect my little girl. Thank you, John, and now thank you, Luke.
Fly me to the moon, let me play among the stars, and let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore.
Olivia, I love you.
In other words, Luke, I love you.
You are my best friend.
You're my best friend.
Today I give myself to you in marriage. In other
words, I promise to encourage and inspire you.
To laugh with you and to comfort you.
In times of sorrow and struggle.
I promise to love you.
In good times and in bad.
When life seems easy.
When it seems hard.
When our love is simple and when it is an effort.
I promise to cherish you.
These things I give to you today.
These things I give to you today.
And all the days of our life.
And all the days of our life. If I wrote down all the characteristics of a spouse for Olivia, it would be the definition of Luke. I couldn't be more excited to see the rest of their story. And then one day I was talking to a client and she told me this story about her father and a piece of paper that hung up in his office for the 30 years that he was married to his wife. When I heard the words, they really resonated with me. It's words for a successful marriage. The five most important words are, I am proud of you. The four most important words are, what do you think? Three most important words, I love you. Two most important words, thank you. And the most important word, and this is important, is us. So with that, please raise your glass and cheers to the new Mr. and Mrs. Winter. Cheers, big ears.
It's the three F's to success in life, okay? So the first F is friends. And I look out here and I see nothing but good friends that you guys have created your entire life. And that's a true testament to the good people that you are. You guys are great people, good friends. And I just ask the friends out there to continue to support our beautiful couple here. Let's continue to support them. Second F is family. And what? There's two great families here tonight. The Bazellis and the Winter family now come together for our new family, and they're creating their new lives together. It's actually friends, family, and faith. Faith in God, faith in each other, faith in yourself. Stay positive, keep the faith.
It's in your eyes, 'cause in your eyes there's a spark. I wanna die.